The story I have to tell is a strange one, perhaps unbelievable. I'll try to set it down as simply as I can. I do not expect to be disturbed in my literary labors, for I'm writing this in the condemned cell. Let us say my name is Murphy. The unusual occurrence which led me here concerns my relations with another man, whom we shall call Kelly. Both of us were taxidermists. I will not attempt a treatise on what a taxidermist is. The word is ugly and inadequate. Certainly it does not convey to the layman that such an operator must combine the qualities of zoologist, naturalist, chemist, sculptor, artist, and carpenter. Who would blame such a person for showing some temperament now and again, as I did? Kelly carried on a taxidermy business, and I was his assistant. He was the boss, a swinish, overbearing, mean boss, a bully, a sadist. He hated me, but enjoyed his hatred too much to sack me. He knew I had a real interest in the work and a desire to broaden my experience. For that reason, he threw me all the commonplace jobs that came in. One day, the atmosphere in the workshop had been even fouler than usual, with Kelly in a filthier temper than usual. I had spent the forenoon finishing a cap, and at about lunchtime put it on the shelf where he left completed orders. I could nearly hear him glaring at it.
Where the hell's the tail?
There is no tail. It's a Manx cat.
How do you know it's a Manx cat? How do you know it isn't a real cat that lost its tail in a car accident or something?
Well, if I may permit myself a disquisition on cats in general, mention there is a clear distinction in mass and body frame of a species, Felis minua, Felis silvestris, Felis libica. The lack of a tail, the fine coat, the body frame, it's clearly unique of the Manx cat.
Slob.
I didn't really hurt him. He's just dragging this out to try and make me nervous. He's not gonna get me. Where's the tail? It's a Manx cat, you idiot. Don't call me an idiot. Yeah? You are an idiot. I'll beat you over the head. Kill you. Wait a minute. Maybe it really was hurt. I better go check on him.
Kelly was just as I had left him. I could find no pulse. I rolled him over on his back and examined his eyes, for I've seen more lifeless eyes in my day than most people. Yes, there was no doubt. Kelly was dead. I had killed him. I was a murderer. I walked the streets for a while, trying to avoid panic, trying to think rationally, Inevitably, I was in a public house.
The warden led a prisoner down the hallway.
Murphy, where's that deadbeat boss here? He's still owed $20. Deadbeat! What the hell is the matter with you? I'm glad you see him.
Well, I
you better order a drink. You're looking serious again.
As always,
where's Kelly? Usually gets here before you.
How should I know?
Yeah, I know who stuffed the pigeon from the wrong side of the workbench today.
Give me scotch on the rocks here.
I'll make it a double. Maybe if I get you drunk enough, you'll tip me this time.
Hey, Kelly still owes me $20. Bastard. Probably will never pay me. You just can't stand to lose.
Yeah.
I wish I would have won that money. He'll never play me again.
He can't.
What? You ready to leave town?
Well, you can say that.
Well, what the hell are you talking about, Murphy? What's the matter with you?
I'm not talking to you. I didn't do anything. I come here thinking I get your vodka breath all over me. I, for information, I played him at the tables too and beat him. He never paid me either. So, you probably won't get paid. What am I talking to you for?
Exactly. Why do I bother with you two?
Here's your $20. It's money well spent if it gets you shut up.
Thanks.
Kelly, he's not available right now.
Yeah, well, tell him it's Joe. It's about our natural museum project that we're working on.
Well, if he's not here.
You just said he was available. Where is he?
I said he wasn't available. He should be back at about 4.
All right, good. I'll come back at 4.
No, do you need to talk to him?
Yes, I need to talk to him. Jesus Christ, I need to talk to him. Is he going to be back at 4? If he's going to be back at 4, I want to talk to him at 4.
Well, I think he was going to a conference down south.
He didn't tell me about no goddamn conference. All right, tell him that Joe is here. He needs to talk to him, all right?
All right. Jeez, I'm going to have to think of something else.
Hey, Kelly, where have you been, man?
How you doing?
Where have you been?
He didn't tell me nothing.
Man, he was supposed to leave you a message.
No, I didn't get no message, man.
Yeah. I've got your mail in my office, you know, just drop by whenever. Pick it up.
All right, good.
Good seeing you again.
Okay.
All right, where the fuck is my money?
What money?
You were here that money from last week. The boss is pissed. I'm supposed to break your arm.
I can get it to you by Friday.
You better have every fucking nickel by Friday, and you guys will consider yourself dead.
I will. I'll get it to you by Friday.
Better. Don't shit around me.
I decided not to remove Kelly's skin the first night I spent in his bed, but to try to get the rest of my plan of campaign perfected and into sharper focus. I eventually decided that Kelly should announce to various people that he was going to a very good job in Canada, that he has sold his business to his assistant, Murphy.
Get it off.
I would then burn the skin. I would own a business. And what is more stupid than vanity, I could secretly flatter myself that I had committed the perfect crime.
I'm sorry, but I've been looking.
Yeah, I say that I had overlooked something.
Have you seen him?
I was just on the verge of calling you, mainly to find out where he was, you know.
I don't know, this just isn't like him. He always pays his rent. First thing. I can't find him anywhere. I think I'm gonna call the police.
Call the police? Well, I think it's a real good idea. If you wouldn't mind letting me know where he turns up.
Sure.
I thought it not wise to dissuade her. My disappearance would eventually come to be accepted, I thought. My Kelliness, so to speak, was permanent.
We'd like to ask you a few questions.
Okay.
This man Murphy has been reported missing by several people. Have you seen him?
No, I haven't.
When have you last seen him?
Did he seem upset or disturbed?
Well, he was the impetuous type. I recently had to reprimand him for bad work, but on similar occasions, he's threatened to leave and go back, you know, go to work in England.
Have you gone away yourself?
I've been to Cork for a few days.
On business?
Yeah, some people were down there starting some sort of natural museum. Some technical school people, that sort of thing.
The casual manner of these men worried me, but I was sure they did not suspect the truth, and that they were genuinely interested in tracing Murphy. Still, I knew I was in danger without knowing the exact nature of the threat I had to counter. They showed me a search warrant. It was purely a formality. It had to be done in cases of all missing persons. They were sorry for upsetting the place during my working out. A few days later, the casual gentleman called and put me under arrest for the willful murder of Murphy. Of myself, they proved the charge in due course with all sorts of painfully amassed evidence, including the remains of human bones in a furnace. I was sentenced to death. Even if I can now prove that Murphy still lived by shedding the accursed skin, what help would that be? Where, they would ask, is Kelly?
Touch turns gold.